smells so good. It smells like, oh wow, like a fresh winter day.
Yours might be a laptop or a desktop, but Apple users don't share even the same device name with you. For years, Apple has enjoyed its reign on the smartphone, desktop, and laptop industry, and they don't intend to slow down anytime soon. On the contrary, things are turning up even better for Apple with their newly launched Mac Pro that is worth only $50,000. Why the huge price, you might wonder? Well, let's take a look. Let's talk a little bit about the Mac Pro before jumping up to the specifications. From the starting to end price point, it's very much evident that the Mac Pro, with its specs and advancements, is not everyone's cup of tea. With that price point, without justified usage, buying this would be a serious waste of money. The target audience with the Mac Pro is not the everyday average computer user. Rather, it's safe to say that the Mac Pro is for professionals that need to deal with a heavy workload on their computers. People in the film industry or businesses and organizations looking for computers with serious storage and advanced technologies can be serious candidates for the Mac Pro. An interesting fact is that if you have the amount of money to buy the latest Mac Pro with all the state-of-the-art specifications, you have another choice within the same amount of money, a Tesla Cybertruck. It costs less, by the way. The Mac Pro is an absolute powerhouse for professionals that can easily deal with a large amount of data, processing, application and video game development, film editing, music production, and much more. You can literally assume the sky as the limit with this one. It is without a doubt the biggest update that Apple could give to its desktops and has surely taken everyone away with surprise. Processor. There's no second guessing as the Apple Mac Pro is the most expensive and powerful computer on the market as of now. The standard Mac Pro comes with a 3.5 GHz 8-core Intel Xeon processor. Let that sink in that this is the standard, which means the specs go up from here. The top spec to run a Mac OS is a 2.5 GHz 28-core Intel Xeon W. It also features a turbo boost up to 4.4 GHz. RAM. In terms of memory, if a 32GB DDR4 RAM is not sufficient for you, you can easily upgrade to enjoy astonishing levels of performance. You can easily take it up to 15TB of DDR4. However, the price point for this is one that you are less likely to forget. This upgrade will cost you $15,000, and you might prefer doing perfectly fine without this update. Graphics. If you are giving the green light to go with the highest RAM upgrade, then the most advanced graphics update might seem less costly to you at a price point of $10,800. With paying $10,800, you can have two Radeon Pro Vega 2 Duos with two 32GB of memory each. If you aren't impressed by now, then you should know that Apple's Mac Pro features the world's most powerful graphics card. Storage. The highest available storage for the Mac Pro currently is an 8TB solid-state drive with a 4TB solid-state drive card, Apple Afterburner card. Have you heard about an Apple Afterburner card before? Neither had we, but let us tell you about the Apple Afterburner card. If you can spend $50,000 to buy the latest Mac Pro, then you are surely getting an Afterburner card as well in that amount. It's priced at $2,000. With the Afterburner card, you will have a PCI accelerator that will offload the decoding of ProRes and ProRes video codecs in Final Cut Pro 10. Wheels. By this point, you must be wondering if you heard that correct, right? Well, you did. You can add wheels to your Mac Pro at a price point that you might consider a real steal after paying for the RAM and storage. You get the wheels added at $400. Monitor screen. So with the price point of $50,000, you would expect every feature to be extraordinary and amazing, right? Well, the news for you is that Apple doesn't disappoint. The Pro Display ZDR comes with a huge 32-inch Retina 6K display, definitely better than your television's display. It has an impressive 10-bit color with an extreme 1600 nits of peak brightness, along with an astonishing 1,000,000:1 contrast ratio and super wide viewing angle. You might think that the 32-inch screen is too big, but we are expecting a lot of people to be finally at peace with having the huge screen they've always wanted. The Mac Pro has a starting price of $6,000, and with all the upgrades and the latest technology, all that is added to the price will be another zero in the end, going from $5,999 to $50,000 in zero downtime. The flip side is that the Mac Pro, with its full extensions at $50,000, is only available in the United States at the moment. However, we can't expect it to be available in other popular regions after some time. The Mac Pro is so well thought after and well designed that critiques will have a hard time in finding a fault that is worthy of attention. Or like when you're in a job interview and you say your weakness is that you are a perfectionist. Well, yeah, you can confidently claim that the latest Mac Pro is designed to the nth limit of perfection. The aesthetics. Well, yeah, you might have heard some calling it a cheese grater, but even that aspect of aesthetic has some science behind it. You're not going to find another desktop computer that is as aesthetically pleasing as the Apple Mac Pro. The entire design of the computer has no fans with the internal components. There are three fans in the front, but you should know that there is also no liquid cooling in place to cool down the computer. So how does the cooling work then? It's really interesting, a thorough work of science and art mixed up. There are three huge blowers in the front and one small one in the back. Now remember that Apple wants this device to be as noise-canceling as possible. So the bottom line with this system is that it is designed to allow the passing of the maximum amount of air to the system. There's a factor associated with airflow. Airflow is never quiet, and with the fans in close vicinity, it is bound to create some sort of noise. All computers do that. But keeping up with the quiet theme, Apple has added another feature. All of these fans would work at a different speed, so they won't be amplifying the other's fan noise. Even that could result in some sort of noise, and that is where Apple Fans Control come in. Controlling the fan makes sure that the fans are never working at the same speed or one speed for long. The speed continuously goes up and down, so it is never the same, and you'll never hear any noise. How cool is that? A little throwback, Mac Pro history. Apple has released devices upon devices in the past that continue to wow us with their stellar performances and crazy updates. From Macintosh to iPhone and MacBook Pro, it has indeed been a long journey. Did you know that the first generation Mac Pro was introduced in 2006? When it was introduced as an update and replacement to the PowerMac G5. The interesting bit is that the PowerMac G5 wasn't very old at the time. It was merely introduced a year before that. It had a 2.66 GHz dual-core Xeon processor. The processor was followed by 1 gig of RAM, 250 gigabyte hard drive, NVIDIA GeForce 7300 GT card with 256 megs of memory, and a 16X super drive. These were the basic configurations, and the Mac Pro was priced at around $2,500. This means there was room to move up in terms of specifications and configurations. Interestingly enough, the standard configuration was the same as a Power Mac G5, but $100 cheaper. You should also know that the first generation Mac Pros came with an extendable hard drive feature. The Mac Pro was built with room for 4 internal hard drives. The best part in terms of functionality was perhaps that slotting the hard drives into their slot would mean no extra wires or messy setup. The processor was upgraded twice, first in 2007, then in 2008. If we put all these changes into perspective, then these continuous changes implied that Apple Mac Pro always remained the best and first choice of professionals in various fields for its various features and advanced technology. It's easy to say that we have witnessed quite an upgrade from the first generation of Mac Pros until now, both in terms of specifications and money. So friends, there was a lot of information about the latest Mac Pro here, its standard specifications, its maxed out features, and some light on the history of the first generation of Mac Pro. Did you qualify as a user of the latest Mac Pro? Will you shell out a staggering amount of $50,000 to get your hands on the latest, most powerful, most up-to-date computer that exists? Let us know in the comments below. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you can be notified for the next video. See you next time.